I follow my dreams. You'd think they were nightmares the way they scream. I make them believe.
Hi, guys. What's me? Hello, guys. Welcome back to the channel. Today we have got the Shadowhunters Codex. Compiled by Cassandra, Clare and Joshua Lewis. So through this book is pretty much about the Codex of the shadow hunting world, and oh my god, you can learn so many things. I did not want to put this down because I wanted to know more, and I read this literally one day, so yay me. And as you see, there is little tags, we're going to go through those in a moment. But as we go through, it's literally telling you section by sections of different areas. So I can go to the, I've lost the content. So it has like different contents. So obviously in the introduction, they go through what is a shadow hunter, the shadow hunter's oath, shadow hunter's name, page 4. So, so I've marked this one, why did I not mark this one? Hang on. Like little names there. So I'm just gonna, it says that you can pretty much choose two names, but not like Dragon Rider or Fire Dance or Elf Star or Hammer Fist. So there's some random names down here. I'm just gonna choose two and then see what comes up with without looking, see what comes up, what if I would be one. So we have Maple. So Maple something or something Maple. Don't know what it would be. So I can either be Maple Water or Water Maple. What do you think? Then you have the Shadowhunter Glossy, Glossary, so it tells you more about the Shadowhunter stuff. Then next is the Treasury, so it talks about all the arms and the tools of the weaponaries of using the stuff like that. Then we have the Arts, so it's combat training, the traditional of the Parabar. I can't never say that word, to train things, and how to report a demon. 28. Oh, I've got 2 in the number 28 of armors and other tools. It actually tells you, I believe I read some of this, and the infernal devices. It says black for hunting through the night, for death and mourning the colors white, gold for a bride is in her wedding gown, and red to call enchantment down. White silk when our bodies burn, blue banners when the lost return, flame for the birth of Nephilim, and to wash away our sins, grey for our knowledge, bliss untold, bone for those who does not grow old, saffron lights of the victory march, green will mend our broken hearts, silver for the demon tower, and bronze to summon wicked power. That was an old Nephilim children rhyme, and I was very intrigued by it. Okay, and next is, there's 3 parts of the Beastery. So the first one is about the demonology. So you learn about what are demons, how do you kill them, the void and the demon city of the pandemonium, and then demons. So you learn about so many demons, what they are, what the demons are, how you can use, like, kill them and stuff like that. I was very intrigued by that. Then the Beastery part 2 is about downworlders, werewolves, little vampires, warlocks and fairies. And there's a lot to know about those ones. Oh my gosh, I did not expect that. And also, as you're going through the book, it looks like someone's also going through the book with you and answering these questions, and that you think, oh, well, what about that one? This person went through the book and like wrote in it, but not like actually wrote in the book, which was definitely quite cool because I did not expect that at all. The Beastery part 3 is about angels and men. Angels and the mundanes, the forsaken, and the ghosts and the dead. So they're asking about if ghosts are the real. They're saying yes, but don't. I remember like mummies and stuff like that are not real at all. Haunted taxis, stuff like that, they're not real. Then we have the Grimoire, who talks about the introduction note of magic, why, glamours of the sight, angelic magic, and demonic magic too. Talking about those ones though, that was quite the story to go through about all these and what comes to it. Next is the Sedlex Durelex, I hope I've pronounced that right. The law is hard, but it is law. The life of a shadow hunter, silent brothers and the iron sisters. So it tells us more about the past. Then you have the Jewel of Coffee, Idris, the Nephilim Homeland, Ataclan, the Silent City, the Adamant Central, and the Institute of the Clave. I hope I said those names right. Well, probably didn't. But those are telling us about the places where you've heard from of the books. Then lastly, it's talking about the history of Nephilims, the before the Nephilims, the rise of the Nephilims in the world, the hunt and the Sarkism and the Accords. And then you obviously got the Ninth Accords 1992. So it goes through all those situations with those, and it's definitely like, oh my god, what the heck is going on through this book? But it does tell you a lot. So if you go and watch Shadowhunters or read Shadowhunters again, you'd be like, oh, I know what that is. I've got an image in my mind, even if you didn't see it in the series. All right. Next is the marks. I just got sticky notes happening. So these are like three pages of runes. And these are tables of select marks. So you can have bridge, calm, anger, clarity, communication, courage in combat, craft, creation, destined, deflect slash block. You can have endurance, enlightened, equilibrium, expectations, fireproof, flexibility, fortitude, fortune, friendship. Gift, good luck, guidance, heat, heightened speed, insight or foresight, Israel, the heel, knowledge, loyalty, manifest, mental excellence, nourishment, opportunity, preserve, persuade, power, precise. Then you've got promise, propensity, protected, quietude, recall, remembrance, slash mourning, sharing, soundness, speaking tongue, stamina, stealth, strength, success, straw striking, sure footed, swift, talent, technique, transmission, truth north, trust, understanding, unseen, visible, vision, voyance, waterproof, wooden union, and winged. So those ones are like the main ones they use. But obviously you don't see the one that Clary makes up. As we go through the book, we see loads of art styles and stuff like that, which I find really good. And I dropped the other sticky note on the floor. Other stuff on the floor as well. At the back is actually some artwork. So I think that's cool. Definitely you find that actually so amazing. It's like, it feels like you're interacting with the book as well as you're going through it, and it's really, really interesting. And then that one. And then we have this colored one. As you can see, that front there looks like Clary and Jace. Like, it's really hard to open something inside the book, okay? So that you see with all the Shadowhunters. You can see in the back. But if you turn it this way, those are the fairies from the Infernal Devices. Because I can recognise Jem by the looks of it, because he's white hair. So that's really cool, and I like that about this. Okay, so I think that's it. Next up, guys, is the Bane Chronicles, and that's every single book and every single little chronicles we know about them, about Bane, which is going to be interesting to see what is actually in that book. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time for the next book. Bye bye for now.